Hi students, in this session I am going to teach you about the geometry and the shapes of the molecules. Okay, so according to VSEPR theory, so you would have heard the hybridization such as sp, sp2, sp3 and sp3d and their corresponding geometries. Okay, so today I am going to tell you how to derive geometry from hybridization, how it took that specific geometry, and how to derive shapes from the geometry of the molecule. Because often in exams they will ask you the shape of the molecule. So what is the difference between shape and geometry? Is there any difference, or both are same? Is there any difference? What do you think? See, for example, water and ammonia both have the same hybridization sp3, but the shape of water molecule is bent shape, whereas for ammonia is pyramidal shape. How come it is? Okay, and what is the shape of sf4? They will say it is seesaw. How come it is? We know only the hybridization. Okay, and what is the shape of BRF3? It is T-shaped molecule. Okay, so all these things we are going to see in a one single video. Okay, so before going into this, I would request you to watch my previous video, which is about finding how to find the lone pair of electrons and the hybridization. Okay, so please watch it quickly and come back to this video. I will post the give the link in the description box. Okay, so before that, we have to get introduced up to ourselves to the VSEPR theory to find the geometry or the shape of the molecule. See, any molecule will take geometry according to the VSEPR theory. What is the rule of VSEPR theory? Okay, see, a molecule must experience a minimum repulsive force and it must look very symmetrical. What is symmetrical, students? It must be symmetric. Symmetric is a nature rule, isn't it? See, in our face we have two eyes, one nose, okay, two ears. Our face looks very symmetric. Sorry, I am very poor in drawing. So our face looks very symmetric, isn't it? So it must experience minimum repulsive force as well as it must look very symmetric. So what are the order of repulsive force? Okay, see, the lone pair repulsion is greater than the lone pair bond pair repulsion. Okay, which in turn is greater than bond pair repulsion. See, what is lone pair repulsion? What is lone pair? Are free electrons. They are not involved in any bonding. See, you know, like charges repels each other, isn't it? So the free electrons which are not involved in bonding will involve much repulsive force, then the free electrons and what are bond electrons, bond pair, bond electrons that are involved in bonding. In a bond there will be two electrons. They are not free, they are involved in bonding, so they experience less repulsive force. The free electrons, the repulsive force between the free electrons and the free electrons are very much greater than the repulsive force between the free electrons and the electrons in the bond pair, which in turn is greater than the electrons which are involved in it. Experience a least repulsive force because they are involved in bonding. Okay, so this rule we have to remember. And one more rule, what is that, students? It must look symmetrical. Okay, so let's get started. So first of all, I have started from sp, sp2, like that. Okay, so let's get started. See, BeCl2. So I'm not going to discuss about how to find hybridization and all, because I have taken an elaborate video before that. So please do watch it. Okay, so its hybridization is sp, isn't it? Its hybridization is sp. So how to assign the geometry of the molecule? You see, if you have to place the central atom, okay, you have to place the central atom, and around that you have to place two sigma bonds. To the sigma bonds, what are attached? Chlorine atom, and no lone pairs here. So if they are asking you to, so this is your central atom, you have to place two chlorine atoms around it, which must look very symmetrical. At the same time, it must experience very less repulsive force. How will you keep like this? Does it look symmetric? No, you have to place it like this, isn't it? This looks very symmetrical. Okay, so that's why, that's how your linear shape came. This is your central atom. Okay, and if you have only two sigma bonds, you will keep like this. So the bond angle is what? So the bond angle is 180 degrees. So that is the idea. Okay, that is how the linear shape came. This is your central atom and here is your CLCL and the bond angle is 180 degrees. See, the only the bonded electrons are there in the bond and it experiences very less repulsive force and you have to keep them as far as possible. At the same time, it must look symmetric. Okay, so the shape is linear and the geometry is also linear. Okay, so then comes your BF3. So what is the hybridization? Hybridization is sp2. So the point is around the central atom you have to keep, there is no lone pair, so you have to keep through three fluorine atoms around the central atom very symmetrically. So immediately what comes to your mind, you will keep like this. This is very symmetric, isn't it? This looks very symmetric. And that's how your trigonal planar came. That's how your trigonal planar came. So the geometry is what? So the geometry is trigonal planar and the angle is 120 degree. All are bonded electrons. So they experience very less repulsive force. So the trigonal planar. So why it is planar? Because everything is in the same plane. So the shape is also trigonal planar here. Okay. So here your methane. Methane, what you have to do, you have to keep, the central atom is carbon and only four sigma bonds and no lone pairs. So you have to place four hydrogen atoms around this carbon atom. So immediately what will you think? You will think like this, isn't it? So I will arrange like this, but what will be the bond angle here? What will be the bond angle here? It will be 90 degree, no? So can you think of a better structure than this? Yes, the better structure is tetrahedral. So what they did, they took one molecule, one atom to the first floor. Okay, everything in the same plane though, so they experience a very small angle, much higher repulsion force. So the better shape for a four sigma bonds is tetrahedral. Okay, so what they did, they took one atom above. Now the bond angle is what? Now the bond, this is what, tetrahedral, and the bond angle is, you know that, 109.28 minutes, which is much better than 90, isn't it? 90 degrees, isn't it? So that's how your square planar came. So the shape is also tetrahedral here. Okay, tetrahedral here. So now comes your, water molecule. We know sp3, the geometry is tetrahedral, we have seen. So but in water how many lone pairs are there? There are two lone pairs. So for lone pair I'm going to use this white, students. Okay, so please see this. So I have taken one atom and I am putting one lone pair here and taking this also and I am putting another lone pair here. Okay, so another lone pair here. So what you have to do, so the geometry is tetrahedral, shape how you have to derive, you have to forget about the lone pair. You have to forget about the lone pair, ignore this lone pair and see the structure. And see the structure, it is what? It is a bent shaped. It is a bent shape. That's how your water molecule takes this shape. Okay, so in ammonia you have what? Only one lone pair. You have only one lone pair. So I'm taking this one white apart and I didn't see the same color. Okay, so here, okay, while deriving the shape, what you have to do, you have to ignore the lone pair and see it looks like pyramid. It is a pyramid shape and that's how see nitrogen. So you have to ignore while deriving the shape from the molecule and it is what? Pyramidal shape. Okay, so that's how you got the pyramidal shape. Then PCl5. PCl5 5 sigma bonds and 0 lone pair. So what you have to do, see the central atom, around the central atom you have to keep 5 chlorine atoms. So what will you think? Do you think a pentane shape, but the angle will be 72 degrees. It experiences a very high repulsive force. A better structure than this? Yes. What is the better structure? So you have to take this trigonal planar in one plane, 3 atoms in one plane, then one at the top, okay, and one at the bottom, one at the top and one at the bottom. So this is your trigonal planar. So here there are 2 bond angles. So what is that? So trigonal planar, so we can draw like this. So this is a triangle, an upper one and downwards one. There are 2 angles. So what are they? You see, here the angle is 120 degree, everything is 120 degree. So we experience 120 degree, and see, this we call it as an axial bond. So this atom, okay, this atom to this atom, the angle between the equatorial atom and the axial atom is 90 degree. And how many equatorial atoms are there? 3 such equatorial atoms are there. And here also downwards, both are similar position. If I invert this, they are symmetric, okay. So 90 degree from the axial to the equatorial, 90 degree. Can you see it properly? From the axial to the equatorial, there are 3 such equatorial atoms. And if I make it upside down, this is totally symmetrical. They are equivalent position, they are in equal position, okay. So these exerts a 90 degree to all the 3 atoms. So we experience what? 90 degree and 120 degree, okay. So here the same, so the geometry, trigonal bipyramidal, and the shape is also same. Whenever lone pair comes, the shape differs, okay. So here next, when coming to this SF4, this is 4 sigma bonds and 1 lone pair, this is also sp3d. So now we have a question, which one to put where, okay. So here I have a choice, okay. See, I have to place around, if I take a sulfur, I have to keep 4 fluorine atoms and 1 lone pair, okay, in the trigonal bipyramidal structure, okay. See how many lone pairs I have. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to take this and I'm going to take this white, okay. So now there is a possibility of, I already told you that there are equatorial position, 3 equatorial position, right, 3 equatorial position and 2 axial position, okay, 2 axial position. So here the axial position and the equatorial position are not the same because the angle differs. One experiences 120 degree and another experiences 90 degree, okay. So we have 2 possibilities, whether to put the lone pair in the axial position or in the equatorial position, okay. So let's try the first procedure. I have taken the lone pair in the axial position, and what the molecule and what kind of repulsive force the molecule experiences, we will see, okay. By keeping the lone pair, okay, in the axial position, what happens? It exerts, okay, see, the it is 90 degree apart from this 3 fluorine atoms, okay. So I can say there are 3 bond pair and lone pair repulsion, okay. 3 bond pair and lone pair repulsion in this structure. And here when I keep it in equatorial position, so what I'm going to do, I'm exchanging the position, lone pair I am putting in the equatorial place now, okay. So in the equatorial place, so what happens now? You see, it experiences this is 120 degree apart, okay, and this is also 120 degree apart, but there is a 90 degree repulsion and bottom also there is a 90 degree repulsion. So there are two bond pair and lone pair repulsion at 90 degree, and this is at 90 degree. Okay, so 120 degree is okay, somewhat it is okay. So among these two structure, which experiences less repulsive force, three bond pair lone pair repulsion or two bond pair lone pair repulsion? Obviously this one. Okay, so now how you arrive at the shape of the molecule. So what you have to do, ignore this lone pair and see the structure. See, it exerts a seesaw model. You see, it is a seesaw structure. See, it is a seesaw structure. So that's how your, see, this is your central atom and two atoms are here and two atoms are here, and your lone pair we have ignored. Okay, so this is your fluorine, this is your fluorine, this is your fluorine. So that's how your sulfur atom has got seesaw shape. Okay, so if I draw this, okay, your axial in the equatorial position, there is okay, so this is trigonal bipyramidal, and this is what shape? This is seesaw shape. Okay, so here BRF3 what? 3 sigma and 2 lone pairs. So what I am going to do in this structure, I am going to remove another molecule. Okay, so another molecule, see what kind of structures I can imagine. See, there is a possibility that two lone pairs in the axial position, and what I did in the second step, I moved the axial lone pair to the equatorial position. Then what I did, I moved the another lone pair also to the equatorial position. So there are three possibilities to where I can put the lone pair and see the effects. Okay, so here first structure is two lone pairs in the axial position. So the lone pair repulsion will be very more, but in this structure they are in opposite direction, so they experience what? They experience a 180 degree. Okay, 180 degree they are far apart. So okay, there is no lone pair repulsion, but what about lone pair bond pair repulsion? See, this lone pair has a 90 degree repulsion with all these three atoms, and again this lone pair which is at the bottom experiences the same 90 degree repulsion with these bonded angles. So there are six lone pair bond pair repulsion at 90 degree in this structure. Okay, so here what they did, I'm going to move one of the lone pair to the equatorial position. So what happens here? You see, the lone pair and the lone pair are at 90 degree, which must be avoided. Lone pair repulsion are very close to each other and experiences a very repulsive force. And apart from that, you have a bond pair lone pair repulsion, and the third one is here. You see, these two lone pairs are at 90 degree, and this lone pair experiences a 90 degree repulsion with this bond, and this lone pair experiences a 90 degree repulsion with this bond. So altogether there are lone pair repulsion at 90 degree and three lone pair bond pair repulsion at 90 degree. If you have lone pair repulsion, you have to forget about the structure. Okay, this is ruled out. Then what I'm going to do is, I have taken another lone pair also I'm moving to the equatorial position. So what happens here, these two lone pairs are at 120 degree, okay, which is okay, comparatively okay, and this lone pair has a 90 degree repulsion with this bond, and with this bond upwards and downwards. And this lone pair has a 90 degree repulsion with this fluorine and other down fluorine. So there are four lone pair bond pair repulsion at 90 degree. So based among these three structures, okay, this one is ruled out because lone pair repulsion at 90 degree, which must be which must not be included. We must avoid initially itself. Six lone pair bond pair repulsion at 90 degree and four lone pair bond pair repulsion at 90 degree. This is comparatively better. Okay, so how they derived the shape? How they derived the shape? The two lone pairs have taken the equatorial position, and a fluorine atom, one fluorine atom is in the axial. And the two fluorine atoms are in the axial position, one up and one down, and one fluorine is in the equatorial position. Now how to derive the shape of the molecule? You see, we have to ignore the lone pair. Now see the shape of the molecule. See the shape of the molecule. It is T-shaped. It is T-shaped. That's why your BRF3 has, okay, so what is the structure? We have to follow the structure, the bromine. Okay, one equatorial and lone pairs in the equatorial, and one fluorine above and one fluorine here. Okay, so these are equatorial, they are in equatorial. Okay, so here the shape of the molecule is T shape, fluorine, and you found out how we got the structure. So if we have to ignore the lone pairs, then if you see, it is T shaped. Okay, so one more hint I need to give. In sp3 hybridization, that is, if the geometry is trigonal bipyramidal, okay, if you have lone pairs on the central atom, okay, be it in how many lone pairs, it could be it 1, 2 or 3, keep it in the equatorial position. Equatorial position means here in the triangle, okay, and not in the axis. If you see in the lone pair also, the final structure has the lone pair in the equatorial position only. Okay, here the two lone pairs are in the equatorial position. Okay, so in the sp3 dehybridization, if you get lone pairs, okay, so it can be any number, 1, 2 or 3, keep it in equatorial position. That is the trick. Don't keep it in axial position. This is an important trick. Okay, so BRF3, so IF3, okay, then CLF3. So all the molecules have the same hybridization and same shape. Then SF6, this is 6 sigma orbitals, and sp3d2, we know the geometry is what, octahedral, isn't it? So what is octahedral? So we take a square like this, and we keep one axial up and one axial down. So this is your octahedral. Okay, so four are in the same plane. Okay, one above and one below, and please check that all the bond angles are same, 90 degree, and all positions are equal. See, if I tilt the molecule, it is completely symmetrical. See, it is no axial, no equatorial like that. So from this face, this is axial and this is equatorial. When I tilt like this, this becomes equatorial and this becomes axial. Okay, so all the positions are equally same, like that as we saw in tetrahedral. Okay, so in a trigonal planar, like that, each and every position is same, the bond angle are same. In trigonal bipyramidal, we had two angles, but here it is not like that. Okay, all the bond angles are 90 degrees. So this is octahedral. So this is octahedral, and the shape is also octahedral. And if you see IF5, there are 5 sigma bonds on one lone pair. So where to keep the lone pair? As I said, all the bond angles are same. You can remove any position. Keeping in axial, equatorial doesn't matter. Okay, so I have kept it like this. So if you ignore this lone pair and if you see there is a square, there is a square planar, and above that there is an atom. So if you check, it will come like this. So it is I in a square planar. Okay, there is F, and above there is one F, and I have kept the lone pair here. So if you see, we call it as square pyramid. There will be, if you join, okay, bonds to these atoms, okay, it is a square pyramid. So the shape is what? Square pyramid. Okay, so here XeF4, we have 4 sigma and 2 lone pairs. This is also octahedral. So I am going to remove another fluorine, another atom, and I am going to put it here. So if you ignore these 2 lone pairs, so what is that? It is just a square planar. Okay, XE, okay, it is just a square planar since all the bond angles are equal. Okay, you can ask me, why did you do this? So you could have removed this and kept it, but all the bond angles are same. So even if I do that, you will get the same shape. So this is what? Square. This is square. And coming to IF5, okay, there are 7 sigma bonds and 0 lone pair. So how to keep 7 atoms around a central atom? Okay, so the shape is, you have to draw a pentagon. Okay, keep the side atom here. Okay, 1 2 3 4 5 side atoms, and one side atom above and one side atom below. So this is what? Pentagonal bipyramid. Pentagonal bipyramidal. Okay, so this is your I. So all are fluorine atoms. Okay, so the shape is also same. Your homework, please give the hybridization geometry and shape for these 3 molecules and post your answers. Thank you.